before we would have to update 40 firewalls sequentially. It took so much time if we had to update like a domain controller. The ability that Azure Firewall Manager gives us to shut down a particular port and instantly shut down that port to 40 different firewalls. It was needed and it was pretty impressive.
Welcome everyone. My name is Jamila Rowland and I'm a reporter for Microsoft Inside Track. I'm here with Beth Garrison, a principal service engineer in Microsoft Digital, the organization that powers, protects, and transforms Microsoft. So, Beth, tell us a little bit about your role and what your team does.
Initially, our role was to manage the connection from physical corpnet to the cloud. We've expanded that role recently because a lot of our customers have already moved to the cloud, and so we're offering a few more services. We offer lab services, so we have a lab environment. We offer a federal networking environment and then a individual customer environment, kind of their own firewall situation. So we've expanded from just kind of express route where we used to manage physical firewalls, and now we've kind of moved into new architecture where we manage Azure firewalls. We have 40 firewalls deployed throughout our various environments here at Microsoft, and we are really looking for a centralized management system.
You mentioned keeping our firewalls in sync is important. Why is that? How does that help you keep the company safe?
The main benefits for me as an engineer is time. I spend less time making these small changes and more time focusing on improving our network service, more time focusing on complex network problems instead of managing individual firewall updates. Security is the second benefit, being able to shut down ports very, very quickly. In a short amount of time, that is a huge, huge benefit, even though we don't necessarily use it all the time. If we don't use Azure Firewall Manager, we would miss maybe one or two firewalls and lose the security ability to prevent malicious intent.
Wow, so because those firewall updates can be made in a matter of minutes versus hours, you get a lot of time back to focus on high impact work, like increasing service offerings and improving processes. Speaking of processes, I know that technology shifts come with shifts in user mindset. With the switch to using Azure Firewall Manager to manage all our firewalls, how did your team adjust to the new ways of working that came with those changes?
I mainly did the proof of concept with another engineer. And when it came time to look at how we were going to deploy it, we engaged everyone on the team. So having that wide variety of people kind of helping us out, it made the switch a little easier, even though it takes less time. It's a bit more nerve-wracking. It's something you have to get used to because before, when you'd make a change to the firewall, you're making it to one firewall that maybe, you know, has X number of customers, but now you're making it to 40 different firewalls. And so you need to make sure that you follow the change process, you get it reviewed, and the change is implemented correctly.
There's certainly more pressure on all of you, but it's great to see the time differential come back. If a customer or team were to think about moving to Azure Firewall Manager, what advice would you give them? I know your team had to move rules manually, but what would you recommend?
If you aren't able to use any type of migration tool and you do decide to do it manually, that you have three different checks to make sure that the rules are implemented correctly. And then I would say take time. You know, someone said recently that naming is so hard in this environment, but being able to have a really good naming convention for your policies and how you want to set up your policies. You can have a parent policy and then multiple child policies. So make sure that the child policies that you implement match up with what your goals are. What we did is we had a global policy and then our child policy was based on regions. So we have one child policy per our number of firewalls in that particular region. So that's how we implemented it. And believe it or not, I think it took more time to figure out how to name it and how to organize it than it did to deploy it.
Yeah, naming can be really hard, but it's so important. What's been the most rewarding part of this work?
We had an outage when we were working on the public preview portion. And during that outage, I've never been more proud to work at Microsoft, and I've worked here for 15 years. So we encountered what we thought was a bug, asked the product group for help. They were on the call within minutes. And to be able to have that type of support within minutes not only helped us decrease the time for the outage, But it also helped us identify the bug because we had multiple people working with us. I even wrote my boss about it. I'm like, this is one of my proudest moments because we always talk about collaboration at Microsoft and we talk about kind of doing what's best for the customer. And this was just the epitome of that. And it was incredible to be a part of.
You gotta love those one Microsoft moments. Is there any other advice or best practices you'd share with customers or other teams?
Take your time designing it. Take your time deciding how you want to implement it. That's one of the biggest takeaways I have based on my experience.
Well, thank you so much, Beth, for chatting with us. And for those listening at home, you can learn more about how Microsoft is managing its corporate firewalls and protecting business critical data using Microsoft Azure Firewall Manager by checking out microsoft.com/IT Showcase.